So the Torah Maqam Rabbihi has two interpretations. First one is that this person is afraid of reckoning on Day of Judgment, and this fear of accountability and disgrace makes him avoid sins in this world. So Maqam Rabbi means he's afraid of standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is making avoid sins in this world. Narrated by Adi ibn Hatim in Bukhari, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no doubt, each one of you will stand in front of Allah, and there will be neither a curtain nor an interpreter between him and Allah. So similar to how a person in this world would fear standing before a judge in court due to committing a crime, and this fear acts as a deterrence for him, the person mentioned in this verse remains fearful of standing before Allah on the Day of Judgment to defend his sins, and this fear keeps him from going astray. Notice, this is an intrinsic state, not dependent on external factors. So this person does not show piety in front of others and becomes immoral when alone. A second interpretation of Maqam Rabbihi is that this person is conscious of the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Maqam here means the status or the station of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This person is conscious of that station. And due to this awareness of his power and honor, he remains mindful every moment of his life not to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands. His conscience of Allah prevents him from committing sins in public as well as private. Both interpretations have the same outcome, that a person is careful in his actions, remains mindful of the consequence of breaking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands, and most importantly, he behaves the same way in front of others and when alone. So we should not take this matter lightly when our actions are pretentious, because this disparity between the public and private is a serious matter. We learn from a narration narrated by Thawban ibn Majah, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لَعَلَمَنَّ أَقْوَامًا مِنْ أُمَّتِي يَأْتُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِحَسَنَاتٍ أَمْثَالِ الْجِبَالِ تِهَامًا بِيضًا فَيَجْعَلُهَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. قال ثوبان يا رسول الله صفهم لنا جلهم لنا ألا نكون منهم ونحن لا نعلم. قال أما إنهم إخوانكم ومن جلدتكم ويأخذون من الليل كما تأخذون ولكنهم أقوام إذا خلوا بمحارم الله انتهكوها. I certainly know people of my nation who will come on the day of resurrection with good deeds like the mountain of Tihama, but Allah will make them like scattered dust. Thawban said, O Messenger of Allah, describe them to us and tell us more, so that we will not become of them unknowingly. He said, they are your brothers and from your race, worshipping at night as you do, but they will be people who, when they're alone, transgress the sacred limits of Allah. So again, we should reflect upon our own behavior, our day and night, our routine in front of people, and our behavior when we are alone. Do we see a disparity in our actions and the way we think or the way we act? Does it change when we are among people versus when we are alone? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from being in this situation where a person would bring deeds, good deeds, that are the size of a big mountain like the Hama, and yet all of that effort, this person may even be, as Rasulullah said, praying at night, doing tahajjud prayer, and yet just because of his pretentious actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ignore all of his actions, all of his good deeds, and instead he will be punished.